as we're drawing towards the end of August, the rains are becoming less frequent and also less in quantity. So we've had 2 millimeters in the last week. So yeah, let's see. But on that note, I'm starting to think about the, I hope the wind doesn't make too much noise here. I'm starting to think about the irrigation on the circles. It's not a great time to irrigate, but I'm gonna just quickly show you how the Venturi injector works, and then that's maybe something you can apply on your side. I think this is a very large scale one that I'm using on a small scale type circle there, so let me go show you quickly. So the goats are browsing out a little bit here. They usually start out on the grass circle here and then they move out into the felt and they go get whatever they think they need. So since they've been doing this, we've been keeping the grass quite short, but I can see that we need to start both fertilizing and irrigating here at night. Now is not a good time. Now obviously a part of self-sufficiency and relying on yourself is to produce your own inputs, and in this case fertilizer. This is Jadam liquid fertilizer. In my case, this drum is 80% grass clippings because I wanted to use it to actually fertilize or fertigate the grass areas. The best food for grass can be found inside grass. So I used grass clippings. Then there's some other stuff in there. There's some vegetable offcuts that I've just added in there, and there's clippings from the bushes and stuff that we've cut off around the house. But it's mostly grass. It means that it contains all the nutrients that grass would want, and that includes a lot of nitrogen. So we're just gonna get a bit of this. It was free to produce other than the drum that I stored it in. So the top of the drum is just a little lid that I made, and this is where I put the materials in, the biomaterials. Whenever it gets a little bit empty, we add some water. Rainwater is best, but whatever you've got is fine. And then just keep adding materials, and the anaerobic bacteria will just ferment the crap out of this. And then I put the liquid fertilizer in here. This is 5 liters, and that is enough for one of those sessions of irrigation. Slightly malodorous, but it's very good stuff. This is the Netafim Venturi. This essentially works like a carburetor. Basically, you've got your high pressure side, in our case is the incoming stream of water. It hits a narrowing section in your Venturi, which then gradually widens, and at that point it creates a vacuum, and that vacuum is taken from this little hose that we put inside the liquid fertilizer. And then I've got the pressure gauge here. Eventually I'll put one afterwards so that I can balance the pressure using this bypass valve here, so that we can see the pressure difference. For now I can see my incoming pressure is 2.5 bars. That's because the supply tank is about 25 meters above where we use this irrigator. For me, it's a bit of trial and error. I don't have sufficient drop on the other side. I need to have both sprinklers open, which means my little 15 mil main line can't keep up with the flow and I lose radius. So that's why connecting the impact sprinkler, which has a higher flow, can operate on its own while still providing or producing sufficient vacuum to pull the fertilizer into the main line and deliver it to the crop circle here.